Hello, y'all. Chef Jeffrey back with another video. Hey, the other day, it was yesterday, so I don't know when you're going to see this video. I did a visit to the farmer's market when I did my road trip. On the way home, I stopped at a local farmer's market. It's a vegetable stand. Been there for years. It's huge. It's in Hempstead, Texas. I put a link on the video, road trip video, and I just want to show y'all some things that I bought. I didn't do it yesterday because I was so exhausted when I got home, so I thought I'd do it today. To let you know, Hempstead is a small town. It had like maybe 4,000 people. It's like exactly 30 minutes from my house to the vegetable stand. It takes me 30 minutes. And where I live, if in the vicinity, we all like a town stick together. We got Katy, you got Hempstead, you got Prairie View, you got Belleville, you got Waller. What other town? Beeville's in there, Brookshire. We all small towns. There's a lot of farmers that raise just vegetables, and some raise chickens and eggs, some raise pork, some raise beef, and they all make a living off selling their products. And I love going to the farmer's market. Sometimes you pay a little bit more for the products than you do at the store, but it's actually fresh. And I like supporting small business people, small businesses, because I mean, they're not big corporations. That's the only way they survive, they. And I really, really adamant of helping small businesses. So let me let you know what I bought. 60% of this stuff going to my mom, because like I said, she's not able to get up to the stores and stuff like before, so she just let me know what she wants, and I know that's what she like, and I take it to her. I got two watermelons. You know, Hempstead have huge ones, but I got smaller ones for my mom. I got a red meat and a yellow meat. She like both kinds, so she can cut it and, you know, scoop them out and put it in the refrigerator. That's how she does hers, and they easier for her to handle when they decide than the big ones. Also, I got eggs here. I get a couple of dozen. These are brown eggs. These are different sizes. These are authentic chicken eggs. You can tell some of them still a little dirty on the outside. These are actual farm-raised eggs. I actually don't even put these in the refrigerator. I keep them out on my counter because, number one, they don't last long, because all my cakes and pies, I like to use farm-fresh eggs. That's why you see my cakes and pies have more yellowy, and people be asking, how you get your cake so yellow, your pie so rich? And it's because of the farm fresh egg that I use all the time and I get from the farmer's market. Okay, also I got a cantaloupe here, and it's definitely sweet. You know how I tell when a cantaloupe's sweet? You can actually smell it. That's how I do. When I pick a cantaloupe, I smell the tip. If you can smell a cantaloupe, that cantaloupe is very, very sweet. So I got one. I'm going to give this to my mom. I got another one too for me. Okay, I got peas here. I got zipper cream peas. Cream peas or zipper peas, however you say it. I got a lot of these. Some I'm going to freeze and some I'll take to my mom. And I'm going to actually do a video on some green peas. I got purple hull peas too. I got both kinds. I got purple hull and I have cream peas or zipper peas, however you want to say it. I got fresh bacon to come from the farm that I probably cook with the peas. But I always get some bacon. You like get 3 or 4 of these and keep them in the freezer. It's nothing like fresh bacon from the farm. Okay. The next thing here, I got local honey. I get this one for my mom. I got one already. I don't need to buy any. This honey is, like they say, it's unfiltered. It is pure honey. When they store that honey in the farmer's market, it's like at 75 degrees they keep it. They keep it in a, it's not a cooler. It's a, I don't know what to call it, humidifier or whatever. It's warm. They keep a light on it. And I take a teaspoon of honey every day. I don't even keep this in my kitchen. I keep this on my window shield in my master bathroom where the sun can always stay on it, because my house, sometimes I get my house down to 70, 65 degrees in my house. I like it cool. This way the honey will never get cool. It always stay at a warm temperature. It's very important when you, especially this one, to keep your honey at a warm temperature to preserve. If you put this in the refrigerator, of course it'll crystallize. It's that pure of a honey. So I always get a couple of these. Of course, I didn't need one. So this go to my mom. She take a teaspoon a day, also a honey. I always keep her stocked up with pure, pure honey. This is awesome honey. It's local honey raised from the bees around here. So I got one of those. Mayhaw jelly. You know, I make grape jelly and blackberry jelly, but my mom loves this and I love this too. I haven't got one. I get Mayhaw to make Mayhaw jelly. So I always keep some of this on hand. This is awesome on biscuits and toast. So I always get a jar of this. I have a half a jar left. Of course, just going to my mom. She says she's running low. She always says, of course, she have my blackberry and my my grape jelly, but she likes this too. So I get a, always get, grab some Mayhaw jelly when I'm in the market. And the next thing I got, I get toasted pecan syrup. You, this is something I was been hooked on for maybe 10 years. This stuff, when I make waffles, I pour this on there. It's amazing. Get you some toasted pecan syrup. I don't know if you can got it where you are, if you got local markets and stuff, if you can find this stuff. You can, the pecans is actually toasted. You can see the pecans, if you can see it, they in the top right here. And it's syrup. This stuff is unbelievable. I can't even describe the taste. When I make pancakes too sometimes, I pour some of this on it. It's amazing. The taste, make it like you got pecan waffles or pecan pancake. So I always get one of these. Also, I got one today. Okay, I got some corn relish. This stuff is amazing. I'm trying to get the recipe how they do this. This stuff is good on black-eyed peas, cream peas. I eat it on cabbage. It's like a second vegetable to me. So it's corn relish. This is a little spicy, not too spicy. They have one that's more spicier, but I always buy this one. I've been eating this stuff for 10, 12 years from this same farmer's market, corn relish. I always get some of it and I always keep that on hand. Okay, and of course I got my pure vanilla. I always get a couple of these. I use a lot of vanilla in my recipe. When I run out, I'm not down the street. I have to use my backup vanilla, but most time this is what I use. Actually, pure vanilla. They turn into big gallons, or they set it like this. I always get stock up on a couple of these for my cakes and pies. And last but not least, these are my mom's favorite things, peanut patties. She loved these things. So this is the reason sometimes I drive way down there and get these. I try to give her one at a time. Now my mom even ate all these up in a month or so. But these are peanut patties. I don't know if you can see find these in the store anyway. They used to make the big ones, but they don't make them anymore. So I always get a two or three of these to take to her. So that's pretty much it. Like I said, if you got a local farmer's market, a local fruit stand, most of these things, if you especially in small towns, most of these products are there. And I'm going to put a link in the video, the place I went to and where it's at. So maybe you ever in the area, Katy area, you ever in Texas, you want to drive by, they would really appreciate it. Like I said, it's a small town, small farmers, and that's how they make a living, by selling their products. And they support it. This place been there for years. I don't know, maybe since the 40s and 50s. I don't know. It's been there since I've been alive. So anyway, I hope you enjoy this video. I was going to do this yesterday, but I just was so exhausted, so I said I'll make a separate video. So anyway, like I say, support your local people, support people in general. That's what I do, because I'm a small guy myself. I mean, trying to make it in this social media thing. So y'all support me, so I believe in supporting others. So anyway, like I close every video, please give this video a thumbs up. Please share, please comment, please subscribe. Please visit my other social media accounts, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, Twitch TV, and oldschoolsoulfood.com. Until next time, have a blessed Old School Soul Food Day. Thank y'all. See y'all next time.